What is key to living your best life? For me, what I thought was the best way to live a few years ago is completely different to what I believe in today. But few things didn't change, such as living with gratitude or living every moment mindfully. In my previous video, I spoke to a friend and a fellow coach, Vivek Yatnalkar, who shared how he found clarity in the pandemic chaos. We discussed many things that day, and today I'm going to be sharing with you three aspects of that discussion, which I have obviously not shared in my previous video, that tie up nicely to living your best life. Listen in.
I also do personality assessment, and I see different types of personalities, right? One type of personality is butterfly personalities. They don't stay on one flower, right? So they will try something for 3 to 6 months, then they'll get bored, and then 3 to 6 months. It's absolutely okay. You know, there was a time when I was young, my parents would say, take one thing and make a career in that. I think those days are gone. Yeah. There are types of personalities who are at one thing, right? You pick up a sport and you become a world champion, you get a gold medal in Olympics, that's okay. But butterflies, please remember and accept and be okay, you are butterflies. Every 6 months, you would need a variety and it's okay. Make friends with people who are okay with butterflies. Yeah. Don't go to people who want one thing for the rest of your life. So, you know, when we work with leaders, you know, we do an exercise called standing in the future. How do you see your life after 5 years, 10 years? Again, those days are gone. You know, nobody's planning for 5 years, 10 years. And when I was doing this exercise with my wife, she came out with very nice 3 Sanskrit words, if I may share. So she said, Vivek, you know, people would like in life 3 things, you know, Ananda, Samadhan, Vikas. You want happiness, you want peace, Samadhan, and you want growth, right? I think those are commonly fitting words. See whatever you're doing, and obviously sufficient money to buy food, right? That's you get that. See what you're doing. Are you getting this? Ananda, Samadhan, Vikas. Every day morning, you get up from your bed, ask yourself, what is that I need to do to, you know, get Ananda, Samadhan, Vikas? If you're going to bed, just ask yourself, how was the day? Did I do everything okay? Or do I need to do something different? I think that's okay. You know, people have measuring scales to measure. Yeah, they will say, oh, you are not doing this, you are not. I think, please stay away from those people who are carrying these measuring scales in your hand, their hands. Yeah, you know, the moment they take a longer measuring scale, you will fall short. Mm-hmm. I think you also need clarity saying, what do I enjoy, what I don't enjoy.
Right.
For example, you are making these videos. I think you have a clarity saying, I need to do it. I need to do it regularly. And this is how it is helping me. And when you make videos, you also get a clarity. Mujhe ye nahi karna hai, to find out time for this. Mm-hmm. I think, so to me, clarity is one fuel. Clarity about health chahiye kya? Clarity about how much money do I want? Clarity about what relationships I need to pursue? Otherwise, you know, we allow societal things to come on us and we think that is a clarity. The society ye karan, like, I don't know if you have friends in Delhi, but I have a friend in Delhi. So she says, you know, Delhi mein, you are forced to wear makeup due to society, not necessarily since you love. Or you are forced to buy a big car since, you know, your neighbor has it.
Peer pressure.
Yeah, peer pressure or societal pressure.
Yeah.
I think getting this clarity will help you to be inspired in doing whatever you do, whatever. Might be, you know, not buying a big house. Might be focusing on social work or, you know, giving time for society or reading or writing book, whatever.
I hope these pearls of wisdom resonate with you and you're going to use it for living your best life. If you have any questions for Vivek or I, you may leave it in the comment section below or you may reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm in. Thank you so very much for watching. I'll see you next week. Until then, stay home.